Listen, it's a great event because first, it's a casual event, which is a bit different from the very big conferences where it's more difficult basically to bridge between people. And there's a very diversified crowd of both South African entrepreneurs, but also African entrepreneurs. And so that's quite exceptional because usually we just, essentially in South Africa, we usually have these South African conferences, but no Africans, or the other way around. And so it's an interesting, diversified pool of entrepreneurs that you can find here. So we've invested a lot. We've relaunched basically the innovation investments over the past 2 to 3 years. It's an asset class that is booming right now, and with great opportunities, both from the investment standpoint, also on the entrepreneurial standpoint. There's lots of opportunities now that are facilitated because of the fact that access to internet is becoming more and more inclusive across the continent, with great growth, and there's great opportunities in almost all verticals. And so it's an asset class that we see growing probably for the next 10 to 20 years. So there is interesting things to be done. And so at the same time, there's an ecosystem to be built. And this ecosystem needs basically people like Africa Arena that helps bring together the different operators or different type of operators in this field to get them to know each other and create links. And so I like very much the fact that there is a mix of physical events like this one, but also an online community, online events. I mean, that mix, I think, is very powerful and provides for interesting things that we can do. And COVID made it much easier to be done online, because online events were not successful a year ago only. And the fact that there's still a physical and digital component is probably the way to go. So we need more VCs, we need more money actually to be invested, because I think that's what's going to fuel the growth. We need also more corporates. I think that's very important, because corporates not only bring money, but that's not the most important part. They bring opportunities for partnership, for markets, for revenue generation, for partnership on R&D. So they're a very important component basically in the ecosystem. And at the African continent scale, the big corporates of the world are not present. And so we need to show them that there's something happening here, so that basically they're more active. Some of them are starting to come. So take Honda, Michelin, Toyota, and others. But these are just the leading. And so we need more of those. Third, we need more entrepreneurs also. And an interesting factor in Africa is that there's a very good mix of local and non-local entrepreneurs. The typical good startup that we see is a mix of whatever, an American and a Kenyan, or somebody from the diaspora that is coming back, but that brings also with them the network that is important to build a company to fund it. I think we need to build success. I mean, success brings success. So basically, first, I think we need to be better at communication. What you're doing here, that's one. So people need to hear the stories that are happening on the continent, because we need to say it this way: the continent doesn't have the image of being rich in innovation, and this is a very new wave. If you look at the numbers and the volume of investment, is only 5 to 6 years that things have started to actually happen, and so we absolutely need to communicate about it. I think we need a few good exits. That's important. And we also need probably to have, better regulations and laws on startups to remove the hurdles that exist to innovation. And so that's one locally, but also regionally. And because one of the problems that we have in Africa is it's not one market, it's like 54 markets. And so we absolutely need also governments, countries, to start discussing how they want to integrate closer, so that when you set foot into one market, you don't have a market of 20 million people, but of 150 to 200 million people. And then you have an interesting scale effect that happens. There is a very inspiring story, actually, of a company that was founded by a Tunisian and that is present in in Tunis, here in Cape Town, in Lagos, and in London and Paris. And these guys are a bunch of geeks. We invested in them where basically they had signed a few contracts with some corporates and did a great job for them in the field of artificial intelligence. And this company basically started working with a biotech company in Germany. And they did this, develop basically research on vaccine, which is extremely complex from a combinatorial standpoint and a statistical standpoint. You need to be able to find combinations that are not easy to find in the traditional way or normal way. So AI helps a lot. And so when they started, I don't think I still have the right to say the name of the two companies, but you probably know about who I'm talking to. And at the beginning of COVID, this company was approached by the clients to say, do you want to do the research on COVID vaccine? And so basically it's one of the vaccines that is going to be proposed soon. And it's a research that was done in between Africa and Europe. This is not yet in the news, but it's going to be probably in the next days. And one of the great vaccines now has been developed by. And so they are awesome companies, not just at the African scale, but at global scale, who can make an impact at a global scale.
Awesome. Thank you so much. That was a great story.
Thanks.